Watch out, boys. Those anti-whites will chew you up. If you don't have the armor on, luckily I do, and all of us do. So we can shake these things off. I'm just gonna talk about a couple of anti-white attacks and how they disguise themselves a lot of times. And some of you may have seen comments by Coastal Rains, the user. This is an old friend of mine, not a friend anymore, by any means. He revealed himself to be completely anti-white, completely anti-me, full of nothing but hate for Western kind and hate for me as a member of Western kind. So him and I are definitely no longer friends. I knew 99.9% sure that he probably still was anti-white, just as much, probably more than he was even in the past when I knew him. So I just want to talk about this example of how anti-whites attack whites a lot of times and how they disguise it and how to handle it. And how you handle it is you tell them to piss off and go back into the pit from where they came. And you just don't associate with them anymore. There's no two ways about it. This is a war, folks, and we don't have time for this crap. We got much bigger things on our mind than some silly little junk like this. We have our entire race. We have our entire people that we're thinking about and defending. So this kind of stuff is trivial nuisances. And the main thing I want to say to deduce from all this is a lot of anti-whites, especially ones that you know or that you knew, they pose as your friend and this sort of thing. They usually disguise their anti-whiteism, and some of them do it pretty well, pretty cleverly. Others don't. But I'm giving you some tips on how to watch out for this stuff. Most of us probably already know this stuff. But ultimately, what a lot of anti-whites do, and what anti-whiteism has done at large, is twisting, flipping around completely love and hate. So in the anti-white world, in the anti-white narrative, they talk about love and hate a lot. And they have flipped these definitions around. So love in the anti-white world, the mainstream world, is actually hate. Hatred for Western kind. And when they talk about hate, they're usually referring to white people that love themselves and their people. So they call hate, what they call hate is actually love. And what they call love is actually hate. So they've completely flipped these things around. That's why they talk about love all the time. And when the anti-white mainstream media is talking about love, love this, love that, it's all about love, just love in general, you can rest assured that that's nothing but hatred for Western kind, if you really want to boil it down. And when they talk about all those haters, they're always talking about whites, and they're talking about whites that actually have love in their hearts, like all of us. For Western kind, as well as all people. And the anti-whites know this. They're just coming up with a pretext to hate on you. You don't fall for it. You call it what it is. You defeat them, you dismiss them, you go on your way, saving Western kind. So, sparing you all the details here, gonna just hit the last and final highlight with Coastal Rains.
And some of you might have seen, he's been making a lot of comments on my videos lately, long comments. And, you know, he's just been going off on this thing about love, 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 right? It's all about love. Love is the answer to everything. Love will save the day every time, no matter what your problem. And then he, you know, got it personal with me, blah, blah, blah. And just talking about how, you know, he's just so full of love towards me, towards everyone, everything, blah, blah, blah. And kind of suggesting the opposite in me, that I'm not receiving enough love, or I'm not giving enough love, and you know, the white positive community at large, you know, anyone who speaks on behalf of Western kind, they must not be getting enough love, they must not be giving enough love, blah blah blah, whatever, they just don't have enough love some way or the other. They always center on this love thing. And folks, this is all a disguise. Now, my former friend Coastal Rains here is one of these hippie types from Oregon. Oregon is a place where you pretty much, it's almost completely incompatible with white positivity. It's so anti-white that it's very hard, possible, but almost impossible to not be anti-white, to not be severely infected with anti-whiteism if you're in certain areas of Oregon, for sure. If you're anywhere near Portland in those areas, I would say you just gotta get out of there. It's just so thick with anti-whiteism that it's almost impossible to get free of it unless you leave there. And that's what happened to me. I had to get out of there for other reasons before I finally eventually came to the understanding of reality in the world. And then eventually, thank God, to white well-being. It was a long journey, but that's just a word about Oregon. That's just so toxic, you just gotta get out of there. But it's this hippie type of stuff. Hey, love everyone, peace, love, and harmony for everyone. Well, this is fantasy. This is not reality, for one thing. I learned this lesson myself. And the most important point is, when these hippies and peace, love, and harmony folk talk about loving everyone, they don't really love everyone. It's bullcrap. Talk about Western kind with them. Talk about white people. And talk about loving white people and showing love for white people and including whites in the rest of humanity. And see how much love they have in their hearts. And you'll find that they have a lot of hatred in their hearts when it comes to Western kind. And so this is how you handle them. Anyone who's talking about love, 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 you handle them like I handled Coastal Rains or any anti-white of this variety. You stay on point, which is our mission of helping Western kind and loving Western kind. And what I said to him essentially was, I just kept coming back to the point of, yes, I do have a lot of love in my heart. Don't worry about that. I love Western kind. I love white people. And then when it comes to all people, yes, I love them too. No problems there. But you bring the focus back to white people. How about white people? Can we include them? Can we talk about them a little bit too? Can we show some love for Western kind sometimes? For whites as well as non-whites. And when you keep bringing the focus to that, to loving Western kind, you'll find that they reveal their hatred of Western kind more and more. They always want to talk about all people, but it usually means non-whites. And you can just say, yes, I agree. Simple as that. Bring it back to whites. Let's include whites. Let's just talk about whites for a second here. You love white people, right? You have so much love in your heart. I do. They are the whites are the ones who need it the most. Whites are the ones that are excluded. So that's why that is my focus. They're happy to talk about any non-white group all day long. They'll focus on them. But you want to focus on whites just a little bit. They have a problem with that. Because they are anti-white and they actually hate white people and Western kind. You bring that out by focusing on that, coming back to that point. You don't let them take you off course and distract you with all these tricks that they spit. They spin all these tricks. Coastal Reigns wrote all these long comments to me. At the end of the day, he just hates white people. And I kept driving that point home. I didn't get distracted with all of his lotty-dotty, fluffy talk, which is all BS. Just kept bringing it back to the main point. White people, Western kind. The fact that Western kind is excluded. The fact that Western kind is hated. The fact that Western kind is victimized. As I've said before, there's no other problems anywhere else. White Westerners, how they are treated is the only problem. So that's why it needs to be focused on. We are the only ones who are not loved by society at large. Therefore, that needs to be the focus. And we need the most love. We need to really focus more on loving Western kind. So my main points to Coastal Reigns, my former friend, was just that, you know, he said all this stuff about love, 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 and all this stuff about me personally, and blah, blah, blah. Insults, etc. And I just said, brother, why do you hate white people so much? It's clearly what's going on. That's the only issue, what it all comes down to. Everything they say and everything they spin. At the end of the day, when you crystallize it all down, you just simply hate white people. So you focus on the main issue. You don't let them weasel out of that. So that was my main point to him. Look, you clearly have hatred for whites. You know, he talked about the anti-white narrative, used the anti-white slurs, disrespected whites, showed hatred, said hateful things towards whites. Clearly you hate white people. So why? That's obviously wrong. That's the problem. You have the problem. Your problem is that you are anti-white. You hate Western kind. And I gave him a chance, said you need to go free of that. You need to get rid of that. You need to stop hating Western kind. You need to love your own people as a Westerner yourself. And show kindness toward white people and include white people in all of humanity that you profess to love so much. That was the bottom line and the point that I kept reiterating. You need to stop hating white people. Brother, that is your issue. And I gave him that chance, and I knew he probably wouldn't take it. because I know he was very anti-white back then when I knew him. Probably gonna stay anti-white, especially in an environment like Oregon, like most parts of Oregon. And so sure enough, he didn't take it. He didn't take that opportunity. Now, we give everyone the opportunity, as we all know. Everyone, no matter how much wrong, no matter how wrong they've gone in the past, they can always go right. And we welcome anyone who wants to go right. No matter when it happens, no matter what happened in the past, no matter how wrong they were, the most heinous anti-white, if they recognize that wrong and want to just turn from that completely and go right, then welcome with open arms, if it's genuine. Everyone has that chance all the time, in fact. But, sadly, a lot of people do not take that chance, ever. And how we handle people that don't take the chance, choose to stay in the wrong when we have shown them what is right. Choose to stay in the wrong. Then we have nothing to do with those people anymore, folks. You don't mince words. You don't hem and haw in that kind of a situation. If they make it very clear that they see your point and they just want to be anti-white in so many words, then you say, piss off, you anti-white. Go screw yourself. So, if they're going to stay anti-white, you don't have anything to do with them. Hopefully one day they can change their ways, but we're not waiting around for that. They know the right way. They can walk through that door anytime they want. Until that day comes, we are completely far away from them, want nothing to do with them. A lot of times that day never comes for people, so they can piss off and crawl back into a pit. And I'll just give the last comment that I just read today from Coastal Rains. They really revealed his sentiment. So it's been going on back and forth, and he's been talking about love. I need to love myself, blah, blah, blah. And this and that. And I said, look, I do love myself, brother. I love my people as well. You don't. You're the one with the issue. And he talks about the old days when him and I knew each other, hung out, and everything. And really what he was reminiscing on is the old anti-white days when I was stuck in anti-whiteism without realizing it. He wants me to go back to those anti-white days, back to being brainwashed. Not gonna happen. I know too much and have come too far to be fooled by that junk again. But I'll just read the last and final comment after he sent so many messages about so-called love. This is where they will reveal their real feelings. If you just keep the point about white people and loving white people, that's it, folks. You just keep talking about loving white people. If you just keep talking about loving white people, you will find their hatred comes out. They don't like talk about loving white people. They don't like hearing that. They don't like hearing love and white people in the same sentence because they hate white people. They have the problem. And it also reminds them that they're full of crap when they talk about loving all of humanity and so on and so forth. It reminds them that they're in the wrong and that they lie about it constantly. And constantly put all this crap out there about loving everyone. You reminding them that they're completely full of shit. They don't like being reminded that they're full of shit. They don't like being reminded that they're the ones that actually hate. one group of people based on race, that they're in the wrong. You keep that point as the main point. That's what I did, and eventually all that love talk about, I got so much love for you, brother, I just wanna hang out with you again, blah, 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 like old times. You know, just love is the answer to everything, blah, blah. You find it. Here's the last message that I just read. I don't give any, he doesn't even seem to understand really what's going on here, what I'm all about. Or he just chooses not to acknowledge it and uses the incorrect words, just invert everything. He says like anti-white crusade, I'm on an anti-white crusade or something. Crusade is part of the anti-white narrative. You know, they like to talk about Christians crusading and doing wrong when the opposite is true. So they usually use that word crusade in an anti-white way, but he says I'm on like an anti-white crusade. I don't know where he gets that idea. All I've talked about is white positivity, white well-being, loving white people. So he's just disrespecting me and not acknowledging my stance, just stating the opposite. Or just very, very unintelligent, doesn't have simple logic to understand. But he has a backwards way of saying it, intentionally or not. But anyway, his sentiment is very clear that he hates me and he hates Western kind. He hates anyone who is for Western kind. That's the bottom line. So this is the message he says in his own contorted, trying to spin loops around you kind of way. I don't give two shits about your anti-white crusade. And maybe he gets that idea because I'm against anti-whiteism. It's the only way that could be valid, is by saying that I'm on a crusade against anti-whiteism, to stop anti-whiteism. That much is true. I don't give two shits about your anti-white crusade. I only bother to talk to you because you're my friend. Right off the bat, doesn't sound too friendly. Doesn't sound like he's too caring about me anymore. There are about a million other things to focus on in life. The world is full of dumbasses, including myself. Well, that is true, brother. You are a dumbass. And you're anti-white, worst of all. So he's at least gets one thing right there. It's just oddly painful to watch you become such a sad human being. Just insulting me. What does your family think about this? Do you have any loyalty to them, or is your anti-white cult more important? Just slander, slurs, insults, just hatred they're just hurling at you, at me in this case. The irony is that you're actually promoting anti-white sentiment by spreading your hate on YouTube. Anti-white slurs, lies, inversions, bullshit. It appears to me that you are anti-white. Just comical. Do you expect people to listen to your words and walk away thinking white people are great? Yes, I do. It appears that you are extremely anti-white. Your messaging certainly dissuades people from having any respect for you. When did this transition happen? How did this happen? I would love to see a video where you talk about how you used to be a caring and loving guy that was spreading positive vibrations, but one day you decided to spread hate. What caused the change? That would make an interesting video. So, you know, he's just spinning all these insults out here using anti-white slurs. And again, what he calls love, I used to be loving. Well, that was when I was brainwashed with anti-whiteism. That was when I was totally inside the anti-white narrative. That's what he calls love. That's what anti-whites call love, inside the anti-white narrative. In reality, that is hatred toward whites. And now, of course, he calls me hate, filled with hate. Because now I actually have love in my heart for Western kind, the only group that is hated by society at large. And I told him this before in a previous comment, that brother, you need to expand your love. I love all people, including whites. You love all people except for whites. I'm just including whites. So I gave him that chance, just include whites in your so-called love for humanity. He absolutely refuses to do this. This is the final straw, absolutely, completely clear. So he just, you know, the hatred comes out. And I knew this would be the case because I knew how anti-white he was then. I know most likely he's probably even more anti-white now. I knew this would be the outcome of this whole exchange, ultimately. Ultimately, he reveals his hatred of white people with certainty, and his hatred of me, therefore, as a white person. So that one didn't sound like he really cared about me, because he doesn't. He doesn't give a rat's ass about me, guaranteed. Or any white person, guaranteed. Or probably any of humanity, guaranteed. All this love talk is hatred, and it's mostly directed at Western kind. Guaranteed every time, folks. So we all know this, we all get the idea here. So that revealed his hatred of Western kind, revealed his dislike of me, and revealed his anti-white stance, just once and for all. So this is what you find, folks. You just keep talking about loving white people, and they'll reveal their hatred of all whites, including you as a white. So they don't like white people. They don't like any white person, most especially, that loves white people. Any white that is not anti-white, any white that does not hate themselves as he does, any white that loves themselves as a white and loves white people, their people as a whole, anti-whites obviously hate that. They despise that. They disdain that more than anything. So that's it, folks. You just keep focusing on your love for white people. Your love for Western kind, their hatred comes out. So this, the final straw for me. I gave him more than enough chances before in several comments, exchanges already. So my response here is, we are done, finito. My response to all that was, okay, you've made your stance very clear. It's very simple. You've made your stance crystal clear. You are a staunch anti-white, essentially is what I said in abbreviated form. You are a staunch anti-white. You're absolutely set on staying that way. Piss off. It's essentially what I said. You've made your stance very clear. We let them define their stance. It's their choice. If they want to be with us, great, we're arm in arm. If they want to be against us and they are set on being our adversary, then we treat them as such and we handle them as such. And it's no more friendly Mr. Nice Guy, it's piss off. You have made yourself our adversary. Therefore, we defeat you as our adversary and have nothing to do with you. Get as far away from these people as we can. So essentially, that's what I told him. Okay, you've made your stance very clear. You hate white people. You are anti-white, clearly. Therefore, you hate me. You hate all white people. You're anti-white. You hate me as a white person, a member of Western kind. So, you know, there's no reason for him and I to have any more interaction. He's completely opposed to everything that I stand for, which is the well-being of Western kind. He is completely opposed to me, white well-being, and all of my people as a whole, Western kind. Completely as opposite can get, me and him. So you just say, you've made your stance clear, you're anti-white, you're against me, piss off. And have a nice life, or don't. Crawl back into a hole. That's how you handle these folks, and you are done. So then I blocked him. There's no more back and forth. You're done, folks. You don't even entertain any of their bull crap anymore. We don't have time for this. Don't have to see his nonsense comments anymore. He had his chance. He blew his chance. That's it. We're not going to be hearing from him anymore. So that's how we handle that, folks, once and for all. And a lot of people like to do this thing. I've had other comments on here. You stop loving yourself. I always talk about this love. You don't have love in your heart. You don't love yourself. You don't love others. This is all trickery, folks. They just don't like the fact that you're loving Western kind. They don't like the fact that you are loving yourself. They are the ones with hatred in their hearts toward all of Western kind and toward you as a member of Western kind. These are the ones that are so cowardly and have so no spine at all that they can't even admit their own position. They have to always pretend like they're the ones full of love and they're in the right all the time. These are the most disgusting kind of people, folks. They're full of hatred and wrongness, and they cannot admit it at all. If an anti-white can at least admit they're anti-white, then that's better. At least they know their stance. But these kind of people that have a vile hatred for whites and pretend that they're the most loving people on planet Earth all the time are the most disgusting people ever, folks. Get away from them. Once and for all, don't fall for this trickery. Oh, you don't have enough love. I just want to love you. They don't want to love you. This former friend of mine, Coastal Rains, if he saw me, he would not want to help me. He would not have any good intent toward me. It would be completely adversarial, and I would handle him as such. So it's no more being duped. Like he is. He wants to stay in that world. I'm not in that world anymore, in that anti-white narrative. Finally got out of that world a while ago, never going back. Free from all that hatred of white people. Free from all that.